transport layer security, as we looked at in the previous video, does a great job of encrypting and doing data integrity for packets and protecting those packets as they're crossing a network. However, it's not the only protocol that can do that. One of the families of protocols that's dedicated to doing that for VPN use is called IP, capital I, capital P, lowercase SEC. And that's what I'd like to talk with you about in this video. So the purpose of IPsec is two main things, and that is privacy, which we are going to get through encryption, and also data integrity, which we are going to get primarily through some kind of a hashing algorithm or its cousin HMAC. And we generally are going to apply IPsec as we're going over untrusted networks or networks that we want to protect the packets as they cross. So if we wanted to, let's take this as an example. Maybe this is the internet. That certainly would be an untrusted network. What we could do is we could build a logical tunnel over the network. And a tunnel has two endpoints. So if R1 is one endpoint and R2 is the other, those would be the ends of the IPsec tunnel. So if traffic from a user like Bob here was sending traffic that was going from 10.1.0.50 to 10.2.0.50, it would hit this router, and based on its instructions, if it said, hey, everything from 10.1.0 to 10.2.0 encrypt, it would then encrypt the data and do hashing based on the rules that we set up. It would then forward it. It would put a new IP header on it. The source address would be itself, the destination would be the other end of the tunnel, and then the payload would be the original packet, but all encrypted. And that way, people on the internet who eavesdrop without the keys involved would only be able to go ahead and see gobbledygook. They wouldn't be able to make sense of the payload. So it gets encrypted, shipped over the tunnel to R2, who decrypts it, and then it forwards it on its way. Now, in the world of IPsec, there are two big camps. There is IKE version 1. IKE stands for Internet Key Exchange, and version 1 means old. And IKE V2, which is more modular, more moving parts, and more compatible with other vendors. Because if you have Cisco and you have other vendors and they're all using IKE V2, there's more compatibility involved. So I have separate sets of videos that are going to go into great detail on both IKE V1 and IKE V2, but I wanted to introduce it here as one of the components that we're going to leverage in the world of cryptography for protecting packets as they're being sent over a network, and that is the family of protocols included in IPsec. So one of the other questions that comes up when dealing with IPsec and IPsec virtual private networks, basically tunnels of IPsec traffic, is how do we make sure that, you know, router 1 and router 2 are actually talking to the right devices? How can they prove to each other that they are who they claim to be? And we have two basic options for that with IPsec, and we're going to take a look at those authentication options in the next video. So I'll see you there in just a moment. Meanwhile, I hope this has been informative for you, and I'd like to thank you for viewing.